So in this class, we are going to discuss the another important gate, namely TTL NAND gate. TTL NAND. TTL NAND gate. It is the most important family in digital circuits. Before discussing TTL NAND gate, let us discuss the concept of multiple emitter transistor. We know that the transistor consists of three terminals, namely base, collector and emitter. All the circuits based on this type of transistors have this type of configuration, base, emitter, collector configuration. But some digital circuit, the multiple emitter concept is introduced. In such a transistor, instead of one emitter, there are number of emitters. For example, you take one transistor, there's a transistor, base, collector, emitter, one is a emitter, two is a first emitter, emitter two. You say this emitter is capital A, this emitter is equal to capital B. The collector of this transistor is connected to plus 5 volt through the resistor, say R1, this is plus 5 volt. The base of the transistor is connected to again plus 5 volt through another resistor, say this is equal to R2. Under this case, when A is equal to 0, B is equal to 0, both are 0. 0 means negative voltage. The transistor is NPN transistor, NPN transistor. When negative voltage is given to emitter of transistor, that is a both emitter of the transistor through capital A, capital B, this voltage forward biases the base and the emitter junction of the transistor. Because of forward bias, the transistor is switched on. When A is equal to 0, B is equal to 0, A is negative, B is negative, the transistor is on. T, the transistor, you say this transistor T, T is on. Again, when A is equal to 0, A is equal to 0, B is equal to 1. Under this case, the emitter A is grounded. Even though the emitter, this emitter B terminal emitter is given to plus 1 volt, because of A is equal to 0, ground, the base emitter junction is again forward bias. The transistor start conducting. So under this condition, A is equal to 0, B is equal to 1, again T is equal to on. The third case, A is equal to 1, B is equal to 0. So again, it is quite opposite to the previous case. Here, the B terminal is grounded. Due to that ground, again the transistor, base emitter junction of the transistor is forward bias, start conducting, and this T is became on. The last case, A is equal to 1, B is equal to 1. A is equal to 1, B is equal to 1. That means positive voltage is given to the point A, positive voltage is given to the point B. So because of the positive voltage, positive and negative, these are reverse bias. The base emitter junction of the transistor T is reverse bias, it is switched off. So under this case, the transistor is in the cutoff position or it is off position. T is into off position. This is the concept of multiple emitter transistor. Let us consider TTL
NAND gate.
It input, we have multiple emitter transistor. This is transistor
base of the transistor. This is emitter 1, say input A. This is another emitter. This is B. This is a NPN transistor. This is collector base. This terminal is base.
So at base, the base of this transistor is connected to the positive of the power supply through one resistor.
This is the resistor. Through the resistor, this is connected to positive of the power supply plus VCC equal to 5 volt.
You say this input transistor is equal to T1. The collector of the transistor is given to one more transistor T2. This transistor T2 is called as driver transistor, whose collector is connected to plus 5 volt through the resistor
R. Say this is R2, this is R1.
The emitter of the transistor T2 is grounded through one more resistor.
This is grounded.
You say this resistor is R3 and this point is capital Q, and here the point is capital P. Through the point capital P, connect one more transistor. This name of the transistor is T3.
This is emitter terminal.
This also NPN transistor. Similarly, from the point capital Q, connect one more transistor.
This is emitter.
This emitter terminal is grounded. Connect the emitter of T3 with collector of transistor T4, interconnected. The collector of T3 is given to plus 5 volt through one more resistor,
R3.
Sorry, R3 is there, this is R4. At this point, measure output capital Y. Between Y and ground, measure output voltage output. This is circuit for TTL NAND gate. The truth table for TTL NAND gate is input A, input B, output Y is equal to A dot B bar 00 01 10 11 00, means 0 into 0 is equal to 0, 0 bar is equal to 1. 0 into 1 is equal to 0, bar is equal to 1, 1, 1 into 1 is equal to 1, 1 bar is equal to 0. This is the truth table for 2 input NAND gate.
Fine.
Briefly, the construction details of TTL NAND gate. The TTL NAND gate consists of 3 equivalent NPN transistors, namely T1, T2, T3, T4. Sorry, 4 transistors, T1, T2, T3, and T4. All the 4 transistors are NPN transistor, equivalent transistor. The name of the first transistor T1 is known as input transistor. The transistor T2 is called as driver transistor. The transistor T3 and T4, this is called the output stage transistors. The output stage transistor decides the output. The base of transistor T1 is given to positive of the power supply through the resistor R1. The collector of the transistor T2 is given to +5 volt through the resistor R2. The emitter of the transistor, driver transistor, is grounded through the resistor R3, and this point is called as a capital Q, and this point is called as a capital P. The point P is given to one more transistor T3, whose collector is connected to +5 volt. The emitter is grounded through the transistor T4. So across the point Q, the transistor T4 is connected, whose collector is connected to +5 volt through the transistor T3 and R4, and whose emitter is grounded. The output is measured between the point Y with respect to ground. The input is given between the point capital and A of the multiple emitter input transistor. This is the construction details of transistor is over. Now let us discuss the operation of the transistor with the help of this truth table row by row. First, let us take the first row of the truth table. A is equal to 0, B is equal to 0. Means A is negative, B also negative. Already this is the NPN transistor, NPN transistor. The voltage is negative. This negative voltage forward bias the transistor T1. So under this case, the base and emitter junction of this transistor T1 became forward bias. When it forward bias, it is switched on. This is in the on position. When the conduction of the transistor gradually increasing, the conduction reaches up to saturation limit. During the saturation, the base emitter voltage, the saturation base emitter voltage, that is VBE saturation, saturation, this is equal to 0.7 volt. Under saturation, the base emitter voltage of transistor T1 is equal to 0.7 volt. So at the same time, the saturation voltage of collector and emitter, that is VCE saturation, this is equal to 0.2 volt. When the transistor reaches the saturation region, base emitter voltage of NPN transistor is 0.7 volt and the collector emitter voltage of saturation voltage of NPN transistor is equal to 0.2 volt. Now the voltage across this point is equal to 0.2 volt. This 0.2 volt is insufficient to switch on the transistor T2. Therefore, T2 is in off condition. When T2 is off, the transistor is acting as a open circuit. Open circuit means there is a break in the circuit. The applied bias and the ground is not connected, it is the open because T2 is off condition. So under this state, the applied voltage +5 volt passes through the resistor R2 and it enters the base of the transistor. T3 switched on. When it is switched on, it is acting as a closed circuit. There is a link between this point and the ground. Through this transistor T3, at the same time, the transistor T4 is acting as a open circuit. Why it is open? The voltage at the point Q is equal to 0. The 0 volt hold the transistor T4 at cutoff state. When the transistor is off state, it is acting as a open circuit. Now the T3 is acting as a closed circuit, the T4 is acting as a open circuit. There is a break in the link. The applied voltage plus 5 volt passes through the resistor and the transistor and exists at the point Y. This point is equal to Y. When you measure voltage between the point Y with respect to ground, this is almost equal to 4.5 volt. This is the almost equal to applied voltage 4.5 volt. Under this case, the output is high. Input A is equal to 0, B is equal to 0, output is equal to 1. So your output is equal to 0. Then second case, A is equal to 0, B is equal to 1. A is negative, B is positive. The first emitter, the emitter A is forward bias, the emitter B is reverse bias. Even though it is reverse bias, because of this forward bias A emitter, again the transistor T1 switches on. Conduction gradually increasing, reaches to saturation limit. At that time, the base emitter saturation voltage is 0.7, collector emitter saturation voltage is equal to 0.2 volt. That volt is unable to drive the transistor T2. This is in the off state. The voltage across this point Q is 0. That 0 volt holds the transistor T4 in the cutoff state. It is acting as an open circuit. And this transistor T2 is again acting as an open circuit because the insufficient voltage. The applied voltage plus 5 volt passes through the voltage, and the voltage across this point P is almost equal to 4.5 volt. This 4.5 volt switch on the transistor T3. T3 is acting as a closed circuit. The applied voltage 5 volt passes through the resistor and T3, and the voltage across this point Y with respect to ground is equal to almost 4.5 volt. That shows the second line of the truth table. Now, the third line, A is equal to 1, B is equal to 0. A is positive, B is equal to 0. So under this case, the emitter A emitter is reverse bias, the lower emitter B is forward bias. Because of any one forward bias of emitter, again it start conducting. The same procedure as we discussed in the previous case. The base emitter voltage saturation voltage is equal to 0.7, collector emitter saturation is again 0.2 volt, that volt exists here, that volt holds the transistor is the cutoff point. Because of this cutoff, it is acting as an open circuit, the voltage at the point Q is equal to 0, that 0 volt holds the transistor T4 is the off condition, it is acting as an open circuit. And this circuit, this transistor also open circuit, there is a break between the positive power supply and the ground. Because of this is as a open circuit, the applied voltage passes through the resistor and this voltage connected to the base through this point, it is switched on, it is closed circuit, the applied voltage passing through the resistor and the transistor, and finally it exists at the point capital Y nearly 4.5 volt. That is the third line of the truth table. The last case, it is very important. A is equal to 1, B is equal to 1. Which means both are positive volt. The both positive input reverse biases the input transistor T1. In all the previous case, three cases 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, the transistor T1 is in on position. But only under this condition, A is equal to 1, B is equal to 1, the transistor T1 is under off condition because the base emitter junction is reverse bias. Even though it is reverse bias, the base collector junction of NPN transistor, the PN junction, base collector PN junction became little forward bias. Because of that forward bias, the little current flows through the circuit here. The little current flowing. This current switch on the transistor T2. The conduction of the transistor T2 gradually increasing. The conduction level gradually increasing. The conduction level reaches to saturation limit. At that time, the voltage across this point Q is equal to 0.7 volt. This 0.7 volt is given to base of the transistor T4. The T4 is now start conducting. It is acting as a closed circuit. Okay. What happened here? The input voltage here is 0.2, it is start conducting. The voltage between this point is equal to ground and up to this point Q is equal to 0.7 volt. When the transistor reaches the saturation limit, this base emitter voltage is equal to 0.7 volt, already we have seen. The collector emitter voltage is equal to 0.2. And here the collector emitter, this voltage is equal to 0.2 volt. The total voltage now 0.7 volt plus 0.2 volt, this is equal to 0.9 volt. This 0.9 volt exists at the point P, 0.9 volt. This 0.9 volt switch on the transistor T3. This output configuration, one transistor is placed above the another transistor. This configuration is known as a two-term, T-O-T-E-M, two-term pole configuration. So under two-term pole configuration, one transistor is on, the other transistor is off, or this transistor is off, or this transistor is on. Simultaneously, both transistor never switch on. This is the concept of totem pole configuration. And here, when A is equal to 1, B is equal to 1, the voltage drop across this point is equal to 0.7 volt. This 0.7 volt switch on the transistor T4, and voltage across this point is nearly 9 volt. The 9 volt triggered this transistor T3. Both transistor switched on. This violates the rule of totem pole configuration. Therefore, the solution is to insert one diode here, semiconductor diode. The voltage drop across the diode is equal to 0.7 volt. Now, the diode need 0.7 volt to become forward bias. Already here, the voltage is 0.7 volt, 9 volt. This 0.9 volt switch on this transistor. But because of introduction of this diode, you need total voltage across this point is equal to already this 0.9 volt plus this diode volt 0.7 volt, totally 1.6 volt. The 1.6 volt is essential at this point to switch on the transistor T3. But after the introduction of the diode, this voltage is reduced. Therefore, it unable to switch on T3. It is acting as a open circuit. There is a no link between positive and this point, because this is acting as a open circuit. And hence, the output voltage across this point with respect to ground, this is equal to 0 volt. This is the last row of the truth table.
A is equal to 1, B is equal to 1, the output is equal to 0. So under this case, the transistor is off, this on, driver transistor on, and this is off, this is on, but this is because due to this open circuit, the voltage across this point is equal to 0. That shows the last row of the truth table. This is the operation of TTL NAND gate. This belongs to IC7400 series. This is the most important series in the digital circuits.